Hey guys, I want to show you how to make my Haddock Thai Red Curry. It's simply gorgeous. It's perfect for entertaining and makes a great easy supper. So I've got here beautiful haddock loins. These are MSC certified and they're from Norway. They're just beautiful and fresh. And the first thing I want to do is just season it with some sea salt and some ground white pepper. Onto the other side and do the same. Now, I love using Norwegian fish like this because it comes from clean, clear waters. It's so natural. I'm just going to inject some more flavor. Dip a brush into some Thai red curry paste and just gently brush it onto the fish. And this is just going to infuse with those delicious, spicy flavors. So now what we want to do is just slice the haddock loins into sort of 1.5-inch chunks and then just set them to one side. Perfect. I'm going to add in a tablespoon of corn flour to a tablespoon of water. So I'm just going to mix that together. That's going to help protect the juices of the fish as it cooks in the wok. Simply pour it all over the haddock. Give that just a rough mix. It's time for the fresh ingredients. So I've got here some shallots. I just need to slice these, 1/2 centimeter slices. I've got here some lemongrass, so just want to top and tail it, and then just slice it into sort of 1-inch pieces. Could use 1 or 2, it's up to you. I've also got here 1 large Fresno chili. Just gonna slice this on the angle with the seeds and all. That's it. We're ready to wok. Medium to high heat. A little bit of smoke rising off the surface of the wok. I'm going to go in with 1 tablespoon of rapeseed oil. And then just give the oil a swirl. And then in quickly with my shallots. And also my lemongrass. So just fry the shallots until they're a little bit golden brown. I'm going to add in the rest of my Thai red curry paste. And then just stir that together. I'm going to push all the ingredients to one side, add in some more rapeseed oil. It's time for the fish. So just gently pour the fish into the wok and then just let the haddock pieces settle on one side and resist the temptation to flip and turn, because if you do, you're going to risk breaking up that fish. And I can see that a bit of the fish is starting to turn opaque white. So at this point, I'm going to go in with a little bit of water just to help steam cook that fish. And then in with some coconut milk, just around the edges. And then in with some hot vegetable stock. So I just want to bring this to a simmer for a few minutes. Let the fish poach in this delicious Thai coconut broth. And once the fish is starting to flake apart, it's time to add in my sugar snap peas. And they're going to add a delicious sweetness and texture to the dish. You can see that as it cooks down, that curry turns from this creamy white to a slightly yellow-orange color. Finally, for some saltiness, I'm going to add in 1 tablespoon of fish sauce. Give that a gentle mix. And then we're ready to serve. Look at the fish, beautiful haddock pieces there. And then last but not least, some fresh red chilies and some fresh Thai basil. And that's it. That's my Haddock Thai Red Curry, perfect with Jasmine Rice.